In this video lecture, we will be talking about Schmitt trigger. Before understanding the circuit of Schmitt trigger, we have to understand the need and the purpose of Schmitt trigger. For in all digital electronics, the signals are zeros and ones. And in power electronics, the PWM pulse is also zeros and ones. Those pulses have some noise in it because of the electromagnetic interference as well as the supply noise. So let's say I have a signal with noise something like this. If I pass this signal into an op amp, the output voltage Vout will have a nice output signal. In some cases, the noises are too vulnerable and it crosses the zero point sometimes. Sometimes if the electromagnetic interference or supply noises is very large, it crosses the zero level of your signal. If I pass this signal into a op amp, then the output waveform will be completely distorted and it will look like this. So here it is positive, higher than the zero level, so you will get plus, you will get one. Since the noises crosses the zero level at this particular point, here the signal goes to minus Vsat, and here again it will be positive, and here it goes negative here, and then at this point it crosses zero again, so it goes positive side and comes back to the negative and stays for some time, and when it goes up, the signal also goes up. So now this signal is completely distorted and the output waveform what you get is not desired. So now Schmitt trigger comes into picture. The idea of Schmitt trigger is, here we have only one level, right? So in Schmitt trigger we created two levels. In Schmitt trigger we have two levels, we call it as upper and lower threshold. So let's say this is the upper threshold, VTH, positive threshold, and there is another negative threshold, minus VTH. Okay, so we have, assume we have two threshold like this. Now I have a signal, noisy signal here, and this signal has some noise, and let's say it crosses zero, something like this, and I have a negative pulse here, and this also has some noise and crosses some zero at some point. So I have a signal like this. Now the idea of Schmitt trigger is, the output voltage of the Schmitt trigger, will go high whenever the signal crosses the VTH, positive threshold. So the output of the Schmitt trigger will be high, as we said, when the signal passes the threshold voltage. So that when the signal is higher than the threshold voltage. Here the signal is higher than the threshold voltage, so you get one here. And when the signal has a noise and crosses the zero level, it won't go to the negative Vsat, because whenever the signal goes lower than the negative threshold voltage, then only the signal goes to minus Vsat. Okay, so here, since it is just crossing the zero, it is not crossing the level of minus VTH, negative threshold, so it will stay in the plus Vsat. And whenever the signal goes here, the signal goes lesser than the negative threshold, so your signal goes to minus Vsat. And it will stay until the signal goes to crosses this positive threshold. So you get a very nice output waveform like this. So now the signal is not distorted. Whatever the signal you have given, you get a very nice output, but this noise is completely eliminated. So that is the advantage we get it in Schmitt trigger. The idea of Schmitt trigger is, the Schmitt trigger has through two different threshold value, that is positive VTH and negative VTH. And when the input signal crosses the positive threshold voltage, then only you get a plus Vsat at the output. When the input signal is lower than the negative threshold voltage, then only you get negative Vsat in your Schmitt trigger, in the output of your Schmitt trigger. So this is the basic idea of Schmitt trigger. Now we will try to build a Schmitt trigger using op-amp. It is very easy to understand Schmitt trigger if we understand the purpose, the need of Schmitt trigger very clearly. So we have seen the need of Schmitt trigger, now we will see the circuit of Schmitt trigger. We will try to build the Schmitt trigger using op-amp. Now we will try to build a Schmitt trigger using op amp. Let me take an operational amplifier. It has a non-inverting and inverting terminal and one output terminal V0, right? So for a Schmitt trigger, we know that there is two different voltage levels. One we call it as a positive threshold voltage, another one is negative threshold voltage. Let me ground this inverting terminal. For this op amp, if I want the output voltage to be plus Vsat, then the voltage difference here Vd should be greater than zero, right? Similarly, if the output voltage V0, if I want to pull down to minus Vsat, then the Vd should be lesser than zero. The Vd, the difference in this, the differential input should be lesser than zero. So that we know already. So for Schmitt trigger, if the Vin is greater than Vth, then we need to drive the output voltage to plus Vset. Similarly, if the Vin is lesser than minus Vth, then we have to drive the output voltage to minus Vset. So there is a slight difference here. Here you have only one boundary line, where that line is your zero potential. If your Vd is greater than zero, it will be Vout will be plus Vsat. If the Vd is lesser than zero, Vout will be minus Vsat. But here you have two different boundary levels. One is Vth, another one is minus Vth. If the input voltage is greater than Vth, your output should be plus Vsat. If the input voltage is lesser than Vth, V0 should be minus Vsat. Somehow we need to build this feature. We need to include this feature into the op-amp circuit to build a Schmitt trigger. So now that we can achieve with positive feedback, let me give a glimpse of positive feedback. What is positive feedback is. Let's say you have a small positive voltage. Let's say for that first I need to take a portion of your output voltage and I need to feedback to the non-inverting terminal. How to take the portion of the voltage? By just adding a potential divider, I can take a portion of the output voltage. I should feed back to the non-inverting terminal. Now by doing this, if there is a slight increase in the output voltage, then what happens? That will increase the difference, V difference. So since the op-amp has a large gain, that difference will further increase the output voltage, and that again increases the difference, the differential input, and further it increases the output voltage, it will drive to plus Vset. So this looping will drive the output voltage to plus Vset. Similarly, if there is a small negative voltage, similarly in same way it will drive it to minus Vset. So for a positive feedback, you will have only two states. It will be a plus Vset, either it will be a plus Vset or it will be minus Vset. So you won't get any of the voltage between this. So only two levels you can get from the positive feedback. Now we will see how to build a Schmitt trigger with the positive feedback. So let's say I take a portion of your output voltage through a potential divider, and let me give it to the non-inverting terminal. Let's say this is just grounded. So assume it, your Vout is at plus Vset. If the output voltage is at plus Vset, then the portion of the voltage based on this R1 and R2, some portion of the voltage I have given back to the non-inverting terminal, that will also be a positive. So this voltage VA will also be a positive voltage. Now, if I want to pull down the output voltage of your op-amp to minus Vsat, what I have to do is, somehow I need to make this VA to negative. So in order to make the VA to negative or lesser than zero, I have to apply some negative voltage in order to pull this potential to zero. So what is that voltage? Is your minus Vth. So when you when you apply a minus VTH, then only you can pull greater. If you apply a voltage which is lesser than minus VTH, then only you can make this VA2 lesser than 0. If I can make this VA2 lesser than 0, I can pull the output voltage from plus VSAT to minus VSAT. So what I can do is, let's say it is plus VSAT. If I apply a voltage which is lesser than minus VTH, then only I can pull down this VA voltage to lesser than 0, and I can pull down this V0 to minus VSAT. Let's say if it is in minus VSAT, then this VA will be more negative. In order to make this voltage greater than 0, I have to apply some voltage which is greater than VTH. Then only I can make this voltage to greater than 0. So when I do this, I can get back to plus VSAT. So this behavior is something like your behavior of your skimmer trigger. So this is your exactly your skimmer trigger circuit. Here what you V apply is your V in. Okay, now we have to find what is the threshold voltage. What is the value of the threshold voltage we need to find. For that, I'm just redrawing the circuit. For that, I'm redrawing the circuit something like this. So to make it understand much simpler, you say this is your Vin, and then there is an R1, and there is a resistor R2. It's a very simple circuit, and your output voltage V0. Okay, so it looks very simple, right? So all are connected in series. So Vin, R1, R2, and V0, all are connected in series. Now, this voltage VA is what we need to focus on. Let's assume that your output voltage is at VSAT. Okay, let's assume that your output voltage is at VSAT. Then VA will be some positive voltage. Now, at what input voltage, you can make this VA to 0 or lesser than 0. That's what we need to determine. For that, you just assume VA is 0. Okay, it's just closer to 0. If that is the threshold voltage, if the Vin is lesser than this VTH, then VA will be negative. So to find the threshold voltage, we can assume VA equal to 0. Now we have to solve the circuit. So VA, the voltage across this one, can be written as VTH. That means Vin minus I into R1. Okay, that is the voltage drop across the resistor R1. So what is the current in this particular loop? It can be easily determined. Vin minus the current in this loop is Vin minus V0 divided by the total resistance R1 plus R2, right? And that is multiplied with this R1. And this VA is, now we have to make it 0. So we need to find at what input voltage, at what VTH voltage, we get VA 0. So that is the meaning of this particular equation. So by solving this, let me solve this. So Vin into R1, I'm just doing cross multiplication, plus Vin R2 minus Vin R1 plus V0 R1, right? So here you can cancel this too. So your Vin, that is your VTH, right? So that is the negative, that is the threshold voltage you need to apply. That VTH is minus V0 R1 divided by R2. So this is your negative threshold voltage. So when you apply a VTH minus V0 R1 by R2, then you can pull down the voltage to minus VSAT. Okay. Similarly, if I want to find the positive threshold voltage, you have to set the state to minus VSAT. Okay. When the voltage is at minus VSAT, then only if the signal, let's say here, when the signal is here, then your output voltage will be minus VSAT. So now I have to increase the input voltage greater than the plus VTH in order to pull the state up, right? So I need to find this VTH. For that, you have to assume the state is at minus Vsat. So assume by just substituting Vsat to minus Vsat, what you get Vth is another this positive threshold voltage. This is positive threshold voltage. This is the positive threshold voltage, that Vth is equal to you get plus V sat R1 by R2. Okay, so here we assumed V naught as V sat. So instead of V naught, you should rewrite this equation as minus V sat R1 by R2 is your negative threshold voltage, and the positive threshold voltage is plus V sat R1 by R2. Okay. Okay, the equation that I have written below is this Vth, this is positive threshold voltage. Positive threshold voltage Vth is plus Vsat R1 by R2. The negative threshold voltage Vth is minus Vsat R1 by R2. Thank you.